bit of fun. May forget your troubles. Here you are, Sonny, want to buy a gargle for a nice girl?
Gone, you miserable sod! Hope you catch a dose!
Hello, Jack.
Oh, I must say we don't often see such a nice gent as you round these parts. Fancy you giving a gal a good time? Just back from the New World, I.
Come and enjoy yourself, have a good time. It's bank holiday, ain't it? It's Saturday, ain't it?
Oh, delight, Saturday night. Oh, bleeding wheat, you've been hiding. Now your ear, clouds disappear. Good, how the sun is shining.
Good, how the sun is shining.
Oh, delight, Saturday night. Oh, how I wanted to kiss you. Safe from all, locked in your arms.
Is at hand. Cast aside your wicked ways. Cast aside all hopes of heaven. Sing, sing, and let the evening ring with the voices of the brave. Brother Paul, God gave him a special gift. He had suffered with you all, used to be a flannel thief, yet mercifully saw the error of his ways, turned his back on Lucifer. Joyfully we sing his praise.
And me, Charlie Small, never went to Sunday school, never ever said his prayers, only in the snooker hall. He's not too bright, never learned to read and write. It'd be a bloody miracle if you get in to see the light.
Sing!
Pearl, once a sinner, now a saint, led a wicked, lustful life, covered up her face with paint. How high the price to soar upon a barren bed, threw away her wicked life, found everlasting peace instead.
Here's Freddie Priest, she's the beauty, he's the beast. What a face he's lumbered with, uglier than all geese. But when he's about, better keep your finger out, cut you up for half a crown, that's the sort of bloke he is.
Sing like sing.
Little talks aloud.
Sing, 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 sing.
Get your rotten, lousy, stinking, filthy son of a dynamite!
And the girl you all know, who's generally nice, though generally wouldn't look at twice. I'm simple, shy, secure, very quiet, rather pure. And though I might seem generally tough, I'm quite demure. Just an ordinary lady with ordinary ways, with a clean and very ordinary mind. Oh, I'm shy, uncomplicated, all as previously stated, unaffected by the ravages of time.
She prays for us, hopes that we may thrive.
But grub and work and ours is life, afraid she can't provide. God bless us, God bless us, and anything of yours is mine, and what is mine's we own. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. All right!
God bless our Lizzie Stride, she's known as queen to all her friends. Says she comes from royalty.
Also she still pretends, reckon she's a princess.
Yeah!
If she's got royal blood in her, then I'm the Queen of Spain.
And we have God bless us, and anything of yours is mine, and what is mine's we own. Da 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 da, and brother, all right.
God bless Lord Overcoat, the banana king of poplar green. Please keep his prices down and his rotten apples clean. He's gotta make a living, but it must come to pots. That if I catch him diddling me, I'll kick him up the...
Back here, you can have a bed if you earn a tenner, or get a place at the Marland Waste. carrying the banner. Goodbye day, la-da-da-da, goodbye day. Day is too long and too bright, I prefer night.
Don't be long, me nice new hats, and don't you break the feather. And keep your face from the alleyways, and don't go near the river. Goodbye day, la-da-da-da. Goodbye day, take the pain, I thought you'd last forever. Let the darkness cover me, and let me hear the lullaby that only the night can bring. La-da-da-da, goodbye day, take your grey city smoke and fervor, take the dull and dusty light, let me hear the lullaby that only the night can sing. Days are only for laughing, for music, for singers and their songs, for lovers confused by the brightness. Consider they are one. The sun is only existing to touch them and shower them with light. But for me, days are simply too long. I prefer night. Goodbye day,
I prefer night.
La-da-da-da, goodbye day,
I prefer night.
Take your grey city smoke and fervor. Let the dull and dusty light, let me hear the lullaby that only the night can sing.
Keep your face from the alleyways.
Da-da-da-da, goodbye day.
Keep to the lanes where the lamps are lit.
It can't last forever.
Don't you know what the lady's really doing for a living? Is she selling something tasty on the corner of the street? We can give you a little clue by saying she's expensive, and her times are divided between on and off her feet. Now the trade is quite secret, so don't breathe a word to mother. It's the oldest profession, and we don't mean making sweets. Here's another one who's at it. You can see the way she's walking. When she stops and gazes upward, she's not looking at the night. She's waiting for the bloke behind to get a little nearer. When he does, she'll drop her handkerchief and nod the way inside.
The trade is quite secret, so don't breathe a word to mother. It's the oldest profession, and we don't mean making jam. What a life, some of them lead. What a life to spend the old day charming. What a life. But on the other hand, it's true, opportunities are few, and it can't be worse than starving. What a life.
Here, Kathy, come up the alley, girl.
How much you got, eh?
Not enough to satisfy you, darling.
You keep your filthy remarks yourself, son, or I'll get my brothers down here and they'll do you up!
Brothers? You don't even know who your mother was. Come along, chaps, I'll show you where you can find some real ladies.
Ladies?
You wouldn't recognise a lady if one hit you in the face. So don't come jack the lad with me, my friend. Men are the cause of half the trouble if they'd only realise it. I am me and I ain't changing, so why should I pretend?
Oh, you think you are so clever with your fancy dandy ways. Well, don't play jack the lad with me, my friend.
My friend!
Cause God gave me a mouth to use and I can bleed and use it. So don't go starting something you're gonna leave an end.
What a life!
Here's another one who's fallen, you can tell it by the patter, and she's hiding in the shadow out the way. And the bloke who'd get a shock, he hasn't seen a rotten clock, and she must be 46 if she's a day.
Now I'm not at all religious in the true sense of the word, and I've done some naughty things myself, it's true.
That's true.
But here I draw the line, you wouldn't catch me selling mine. But you're welcome to my sister if you've got a bob or two.
Oh, you!
You!
You're so superior!
So superior! It can't be worse than starving. What a life! What a life!
Look, whatever you call it and however you do it, we all want it, don't we? You want it, and I want it. We all want it. Love.
That's what we're all looking for. And whether you're wealthy or whether you're poor, once you have had it, you'll always want more. You want, I want, we all want love. The singer, the music, the song. And if love's not the motive that drives us along, then I'll admit I'm wrong. Both saints and sinners join in its praise. All walks of life play its game. In love there's no barrier, colour or race. Once bitten, the smitten, we'll all feel the same. We want, I want, we all want love. Of that there's no shadow of doubt. It's a free luxury that you can't do without. That's what this whole rigmarole is about. We want, I want, we all want love. It lightens and brightens the day. Fighting, the crying, and that's all I'm trying to say. The highest, the lowest, the strongest, the weak, each gets caught up in its game. Some can't stop talking, others can't speak. Once bitten, the smitten, we'll all feel the same. We want, I want, we all want love. Of that there's no shadow of doubt. The fighting, the sighing, the singing, the crying, that's what the old prisoner.
You're walking down the alley when suddenly a shriek will make your blood run cold.
Creeps up, eyes shut.
your bleeding throat's cut. The Ripper's gonna get you if you don't watch out.
Oh, Lord, what the hell was that?
I thought I saw the devil in a big black hat.
Oh, God!
Another tart rubbed out.
Her tongue is slowly turning black.
Her eyes are popping out.
She was a pretty thing before. Now she's Annie upon the floor.
Look around,
around.
He's coming up behind you. He's got a great big bloody weapon in his hand. Creeps up, eyes shut, your bleeding throat's cut. The Ripper's gonna get you if you don't watch out. You heard about a bloke called Bluebeard. Had so many wives he had to do them in.
Nice talk, talk soft.
He cut their bleeding heads off.
If Bluebeard doesn't get ya, watch out for Swing-Eel Jack.
Oh, Lord, was that a nasty dream?
Or did I hear another Ripper victim scream?
Oh, God!
Is that a body there?
Half her inside hanging out.
And bloody matted hair.
She was a fair old-looking tart. Now she's been almost torn apart.
What was that? A leaping from the shadows with a great big bloody weapon in his hand. Creeps up, eyes shut, your bleeding throat's cut. The Ripper's gonna get you if you don't watch out. The Ripper's gonna get you if you don't watch out. The Ripper's gonna get you if you don't watch out. The Ripper's gonna get you if you don't watch out. The Ripper's gonna get you if you don't watch out.
Gentlemen, to the concluding act of tonight's thrilling performance.
Yay!
Are we all happy?
Yes!
Good!
But we ain't got any money to buy our beer.
Never mind. Charlie's letting us have it on the slate.
But
no one can pay him back.
Never mind. We'll be all right when the boat comes in.
When the boat comes in.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I must ask you for the second time this evening to raise your glasses and drink another loyal toast to our much beloved and kind-hearted Queen Victoria. God bless her.
God bless her. God bless her, Gloria.
Just leave them all to me, provided I can do it sometime between lunch and tea.
God, you're ugly.
You're drunk.
At least I'll be sober in the morning.
You insulting, vulgar little man. I'll teach you a lesson. Where's Charlie?
Charlie! Called your majesty.
Not you, Charlie. You, Charlie. My new chief of police, Charlie.
Noticed I have a very fine hat and a horse with a very fine mane. Allow me to introduce myself. Charles Warren is the name. I'm the man that they push forward when they've got a mob to tame. When there's been an almighty political cock-up. And someone must take the blame.
Now what is this I hear about you killing people in Africa?
Oh yes, your majesty. 1,200 to be exact. who will never see the light of day again.
Did you have a reason?
Oh, yes. They were black, you know.
Were they revolting?
Not half.
Oh, Mark Holmes.
I've battered the blacks in Bangalore. I've routed the rebels in Spain. The wayward wogs in the Isle of Dogs won't cause any trouble again. The sleeping Sikhs in the Tinge machine, I've got them on the run. I've put licorice in their lemon tea and showed them the enemy gun. Oi!
Yes, I hear it's a formidable weapon.
Oh, yes, Your Majesty, especially in the right hand.
I'll latch up and hold of it for a minute.
Oh, you are a one.
Now, pin down.
Oh, no, you're all talk, you are.
Now, give it to me.
Is that an invitation or an exclamation?
It's a royal decree, so on your knee. Now, rise, Sir Charles, me boy. You're now a knight, so go and fight. They need you in Sempoy. There's Opium Market shop there. We'll be rid of your ugly mug. And if you're duffed, we can have you stuffed. Or even made into a rag.
And if you're duffed, we can have you stuffed. Or even made into a rag.
No. Let us get down to the serious business of the day. What is this? I hear about murder in the East End.
Yes, Your Majesty. A politician was robbed to death on Tooting Common. A reward of £10,000 has been offered.
Tooting? That isn't in the East End, is it?
Isn't it? No wonder we couldn't find it.
Oh, I was referring to the other murders.
Sir William Makepeace Thorpe, strangled, £5,000 reward?
No.
Lord Clementine Cavendish, stabbed, £3,000 reward?
No.
The Right Honourable Sir Frederick Nightingale, done to death, £2,000? No.
Polly Ann Nichols, the Allgator.
The fourpenny touch?
Mm. A wicked, wayward bunch of girls who sell themselves for cash are being pursued by a maniac who gives them a right old dash. He rips the tarts to pieces, then rapes them one by one. It's got to be stopped! And I really don't see why they should have all the fun. Roar, they tell you. Very good. I take an interest like a good queen should.
We sing good Britannia, queen of all our shores. There's a rumour that you can't stand wars. Queen of all our shores, queen of all our shores, that you can't stand wars. How's that?
Grass on the other side is always greener, and the air down at Blackwood and half stink. Yes, I'm gonna get away, and I really will tomorrow. But I'll just go down the boozer and have just one last drink. Half a dozen pints on a Friday night, and even living down this bleeding street's alright. When you're feeling great and you've had a plate of the finest mustard pickles in the whole of London, it makes me creep. It's such a filthy street, and I wouldn't give you tuppence for the blokes you meet. But a few light owls, then we'll all be pals. And we're all too drunk to say goodbye. Oh, the world is lovely, beautiful and sweet, and life's one big playground full of fun. But in the morning, it's different. You're left crying in the street, and it ain't all ring of roses in the midday sun. I'll blow your troubles, push them all away. Forget about tomorrow, that's another day. Cause you can't go wrong with a good sing-song and a little bit of I-hopes. And how's your father? Come on, Gladys, get your knickers down and let's all your yaddy-o to Mother Brown. Let us sink a few, oh, good cockneys do, then get so drunk that no one gives a damn. Oh, the breeze is lovely, blowing from the docks, and they say a drop of sea air does you good. When you're sober, it'll choke you. It's a smell of dirty socks. And then you realise the kids have worn their shoes out. The pieman's scarpered and the chip shop shut, and we've all had a knife, and
we're all off cap. So the girls start crying, and it's auld lang syne. And we all walk together arm in arm. See, it's what this place has always meant to me, Toynbee. Great. Oh, great when you're drunk. Bloody awful when you're sober. No, it's nothing to be proud of, and it's not so grand. It's just the way of living here since time began. I know it's not a lot, but it's all we've got. You weren't born here, so you'd never understand.
Coming in, wake up, Jeri-oh. There'll be work, I know, for anyone who wants it.
There's a boat coming in, wake up, Jeri-oh. There'll be work, I know, to make the women smile. There's a boat coming in.
Life worse than
Too many promises are broken. Too many times, too many lives before.
First suspect, please. Ladies and gentlemen, your friend and mine, number 16 on your hymn sheets, the mad butcher from Mile End, Alexander Panachenko.
I'm known as Leather Apron. I'm a shop in Burnett Street. I'm known as Leather Apron, and I sell high class meat. You can hear me all day long, singing out this song. Pigs feet, liver and meat, I'm handy with me knife.
He's got pigs feet, liver and meat, he's handy with his knife.
Suspect number two, that lion serial comic of the steam packet, late Cole Ole, Mr. Foglimar, the singing Norwegian sailor.
I am a foreign skipper working boats across the sea. I am a foreign skipper working boats across the sea. Though I don't know why I'm here, I'm glad I could appear. I'm a skipper on a clipper, but to say I'm Jack the Ripper is a piece of idiocy.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, that comic vocalist with a wit so sharp he'll cut himself one day, your friend and mine, Sidney Allsopp.
Brush and lather, I'd give you quite a treat. I'd sit you in my chair, but I wouldn't touch your hair. I'd cut your throat!
You shot me, sod, you've got it wrong, that's Sweeney Todd.
He's all mixed up, he's such a dick, he's got the wrong end of the stick.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, by way of a pleasant diversion, that peripatetic Cockney Sparrow, Miss Saucy Rosebud!
They're so confused, they're in the world, they say the Ripper is a girl. They're so confused, they're in the world, they say the Ripper is a girl. And now they're trying to say, I put those whores away. That I'm a killer, don't be daft, kill the Ripper, that's a laugh.
I'm a killer, don't be daft, kill the Ripper, that's a laugh.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, we're very proud and privileged to present for your further enjoyment and education, that very right royal and very regal Albert, Duke of Clarence.
I'm a knob from royalty and a high up knob I am. I'm a knob from royalty and a high up knob I am. I'm very high and I'm very grand. You see, I've an orb and a thing in the hand. My cloak is made from ermine, the rest is made from lace. But royalty and custody's a dastardly disgrace.
Hey, how dare you treat my grandson in this manner? He's one of us.
You could have fooled me, I thought he was one of them.
Oh, be quiet, you richy little man, or I'll have you beheaded. Where's my chief of police?
Oh, your friend and mine... Charles Warren.
All right, get off your knees.
Oh, thank you, Your Majesty.
Now, what are you going to do about these murders in Whitechapel?
Ignore them. They might go away.
Have you checked on all the single men living in rooms in that part of London?
No.
Have you traced all the lunatics that have escaped from asylums?
No.
Have you issued the girls with police whistles?
No.
Have the police dressed up as women?
Yeah, I?
In the hopes of being accosted by the beast?
No.
Have bloodhounds been set loose to track the killer?
Yes, Your Majesty.
Oh, God, what happened?
Oh, we lost them.
Oh.
Well, it was foggy.
Oh, Charlie, lad, it's very bad. So off to Allgate East. And Charlie, lad, although you're mad, do try and keep the peace.
But no one will cooperate. I drive them round the bend. For I'm the man that they most hate.
And the obvious man to send. A message to my subjects. Good life, good luck, good health. And if you're wanting something done, then do it your bleeding self. Roar, Britannia. Aren't I very good? I take an interest like a good queen should.
We're saying good.
They gone and dressed me up in women's clothes. And it's not the sort of job I would have chose. I understood the pay was good, the prospects not too bad, the pension schemes encouraging, but still I'm feeling sad. They took away my little truncheon and gave me a little bag.
And they go and dressed us up in women's clothes. Yes, they go and dressed us up in women's clothes, and it's not the sort of job I would have chose.
The station sergeant, he's all right, if a trifle fat. Inspector owns a nice old cart, if just a little flat.
Then Charlie's putting knickers on, and no one said to that.
Oh my God, and he's sewing on a lot of frilly balls.
Mind you, I wouldn't want to say a lot, but Albert's quite enjoying it. He's putting rouge and makeup on and mincing up and down a bit. He's been propositioned 3 times, and he hasn't turned them down yet.
And he's gone and got dressed up in women's clothes.
When I was told to dress like some old doer, I thought, funny, never heard of that before.
It's not the sort of job that I would normally revere.
Oh, no.
Now I'll tell you something you'll be surprised to hear.
Yeah, 1,400 coppers couldn't wait to volunteer.
When the cry went up, get dressed in women's clothes.
I only have to step across the river. It's a step that's not so very hard to make. Yes, it only takes a step a day to be a million miles away. For each little step I take must lead to others. It only takes one tiny little flower to make the most artistic sweet bouquet. Yes, if you're prepared to dig away, it only takes a spoon a day for you to dig the flaming world away. You feel that life has left you way behind it, and every old ambition's dead and gone. If only some small hope remained for you to stop and start again, you'd do a lot of things you'd left undone. No, it's not too late to start a little fire. It only needs one tiny little flame. Yes, it only takes a spark at first to set alight the universe, and every big event must start that way.
Maybe you're right, dear.
Yeah, I know I'm right, Liz. At least that's something I learned from Toynbee. Yeah, I'll give him his due. I suppose you can sit around moaning forever, but in the end, you just have to get up and do something about it. And that's what I intend to do, Liz.
Yeah, so will I, dear. Sometime.
No, right now.
I couldn't, dear. Not with all my business commitments. I might have been a lady or a princess. I might have lived a life of luxury, but my life rolled on a different way, and this is where I am today. Fate took an end, and it was not to be. You might make out a case for never trying, or never really wanting things to change, or that I let opportunity and chances slip away from me.
Look, there's one easy remedy, and it's as plain as plain could be. It only takes one tiny little flower.
the most artistic sweet bouquet. Yes, if you're prepared to dig away, it only takes a spoon a day for you to dig the flaming world away. You feel that life has left you way behind, indeed. Some small home remained for you to stop and start again. You do a lot of things you've left undone. No, it's not too late to start a little fire. It only needs one tiny little flame. It only takes a spark at first to set alight the universe, and every big event might start that way. And every big event must start that
whores with no hope of heaven. Gladstone may save one, then there'll be seven. Seven little whores begging for a shilling. One lives in Henage Court, then there's a killing. There he goes!
There he goes!
I thought I saw him this way.
Which way? Running up the alley in a big black hat. Black hat! This way!
This way!
That way!
That way!
That way.
Every blooming
witch. Break the spell and get you in.
Six little whores, glad to be alive. One sidles up to Jack, then there are five.
Jack the Ripper stole a kipper, hid it in his father's slipper. When his father put it on, Jack and Kipper both had gone.
There he is!
There he is!
Standing in the doorway!
Doorway!
Whore and whore rhyme all right, so do three and me. I'm going to set the town alight and have me a bloody spree.
Some say that he's a doctor, and some that he's a top.
A top.
Some say that he's a surgeon,
yeah.
And some that he's well off.
Well off, he cannot be an Englishman, of that you can be sure.
Okay.
Now Britain would be guilty of such flagrance of the law.
He cannot be an Englishman, of this we can be sure.
Sure.
No Britain could be guilty of such flagrance of the law.
Right, the English are so honest, respectable and pure. He could only be a foreigner, of that we can be.
Little whores, shivering with fright, seek a cozy doorway in the middle of the night. Jack's knife flashes, then there's but one, and the last one's the ripest for Jack's idea of fun.
I'll always to be.
grow, no more affection could I show, than say that no one else can hold a candle to you. Oh, good my sweet Saturday, my sweet, I'll dream of you.
See you, Mario.